What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro DIY. Today we're going to be working on a 2003 BMW E46 M3. Today on the M3 behind me, we're going to be covering how to replace the mass airflow sensor. This is a sensor that typically goes bad anywhere between 100 and 200,000 miles. In some cases, depending on how polluted the air is and how often you change your engine air filter. This is responsible for metering the air that comes into your motor, so it has a big role in how your engine runs. Typically, you're gonna get a code for this once they go bad, so it's a pretty easy thing to detect. In some extreme cases, if you're unsure of your mass airflow sensor going bad, just go ahead and unplug it and see how the vehicle runs. If it's bad, you unplug it. Again, in some cars, the vehicle will continue running and almost run better than when the mass airflow sensor was plugged in and failing. That's just a couple things to keep in mind. But before we get started on the replacement of the sensor, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the tools we're gonna need for this DIY. For this DIY, we're gonna need a very basic, simple tool, and that's gonna be a 1/4-inch ratchet and a tamper-proof T20 Torx bit. I'm using a T20 Torx bit on this small 1/4-inch extension that I can put onto my ratchet. Now we know what tools we're gonna be working with, let's go ahead and get started on this DIY. All right, my good people, under the hood of the M3, our mass airflow sensor is located on the driver's side bank in between the air box and air filter box. We have two T20 tamper-proof Torx screws that hold our mass airflow sensor into place. And we also have an electrical connector here. To get started, you're gonna wanna undo the electrical connector by pressing in on the tabs on either side. Sometimes it helps to push in and then pull out. Set that to the side. And we're gonna grab our 1/4-inch ratchet with our small 1/4-inch adapter and our T20 tamper-proof Torx bit. I'm gonna go ahead and get these two screws out. With both of those removed, now we can go ahead and work on wiggling out the sensor. And now before you install the new one, it never hurts to clean the housing where this is gonna go in. Obviously, if there's a ton of debris in there, you wanna make sure none of that goes into your box. There's nothing on this one, so it should be pretty good to go. We're gonna take our new sensor and make sure your heating element is facing downwards and your black sealed area with the part number and the Bosch label is facing upwards. We're gonna go ahead and install this the same way the old one came out. Give it a couple twists to seat that O-ring in place and then grab your T20s once more and get those started by hand. Now we're gonna go ahead and just snug them up. These are metal screws going into a plastic housing, so they're not gonna require a lot of torque, no more than 3 to 5 Newton meters if you wanna torque them at home. And once we're happy with how tight those are, we can grab our electrical connector once more, plug that baby in, and voila. There you have it, my good people. Another DIY in the books. Overall, a very easy and straightforward one. Just remember, these are tamper-proof T20s, so assuming your hardware is still original and has not been replaced, you want to make sure you have one of those Torx bits available to you. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave them in the comment box below. And if you like this video and you want to see more like them, consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.